It's okay. I'm alive. I haven't given up on this series. Let's create an entity that's gonna print anything the mapper wants into the console. Let's call it trigger print. You'll create a new CPP file, write some code, and then write an entry in the FGD file. The last part is optional, but without it, you wouldn't be able to find your new entity in the map editor. First, you should create a new source file. You can do that by going here, right-clicking it, and then add new item. Make sure you create the CPP file in the DLLs folder, because having sources and headers in the projects folder is very ugly to see. Plus, it's not consistent with the rest of the SDK. Now, in this brand new file, you'll need to include three headers, xtdll, util, and cbase, in this very order. If you do it in the wrong order, you're gonna get errors while compiling, because certain things in cbase depend on other things in util and xtdll. In short, xtdll defines the engine interface, some constants and stuff like that. Util contains various utility functions, and most importantly, cbase defines the base entity class. The base entity class is what all entities inherit from, and so will our new entity. Now, if you're new to C++ and you don't know what any of this code means, I'd still advise you to learn the basics. But I'll do some hand-holding this time. You can think of classes for game entities as blueprints for buildings. When the engine spawns a new entity instance, it'll look at the class and that will define the entity's behavior. So with that said, let's actually design our entity's behavior so we can later translate it into code. It's blatantly simple, but we'll still go through the entity's design the old-fashioned way. Trigger print will only have two key values, the name of the entity, which is target name, and the text that will get printed to the console, that is message. We'll need to know this when we modify the FGD. And when it's triggered, it'll print its message to the console, simple as that. CBase entity provides several methods that we can override, but what we're interested in is the use method. It's called every time the entity is triggered by another entity, or in certain circumstances, is used by the player. This way, we're telling the compiler that we're overriding this method from the base entity class. In the parameters, you can see a couple of entity pointers, a use type, and some value. Activator is the entity that is responsible for this entity getting used, while caller is the entity that actually triggered this one. So, for example, if a player uses a button to open a door, the player is the activator, and the button is the caller. This will be covered some other time in detail. Now, we could define this use method right inside the class, but normally in the SDK it's all defined outside. Start by writing void ctriggerprintUse. To make your life easier, you can just copy-paste the parameters into it, or type them out manually so you can memorize them. Next, open and close those curly brackets. Alright, so now we can make this entity do something when it's triggered. You can do anything you want here. You can kill the player, spawn a monster, spawn an explosion, crash the game, you can do anything. But our goal is to print a message to the console. The way we do that is by using a macro called alert. It calls the engine's print function, so type the following code. The slash n is necessary because it adds a new line to the in-game console. At underscore console isn't the only option, by the way. If you want to find out more, right-click at console and peek definition. For example, at AI console only prints if the developer level is 2 or more. Now, if we compile this straight away and use this entity in a map, we would get a hello world message in the console. Let's make it do more than that. Write the following code. The %s essentially means insert a string here, and it only works with functions that accept this kind of formatting and have the three dots as the last parameter. PevMessage is a number which refers to a string. So we gotta convert it into a string first, using the string macro. In a nutshell, pev is a bunch of variables that are common to all entities. For example, all entities have a position, rotation, and similar stuff. Also, most visible entities have render mode, render effects, render amount, and so on. And that's all stored in pev. The last thing to do is to write this below the class. Don't worry about how it works. For now, let's just say it's magic. You put the entity class name as the first argument and the C++ class as the second. Right now, The only way to put this entity into the map is to create another entity, change its class name, and then add key values manually. That's not very mapper friendly, so let's edit the FGD. Copy your Half-Life FGD and rename it. You can create a new one from scratch. It doesn't matter. Write the following code. This is perfectly enough for the entity to be exposed to the map editor. The class name we defined in the game DLL must match this one, otherwise the entity won't spawn. If you placed this entity now in the map editor, you wouldn't be able to give it a name, nor a message, so let's add those properties to it. Alright, we've added the entity name and we got a message. The format goes like this generally. You have a key value name, then a type, then a description and a default value. There are various types like string, integer, target source, target destination and so on. After you save the FGD, compile the DLL and all that, you can place this entity in your map, set its message and trigger it. Now honestly, this video could have been split into three parts. One for the SDK overview and what does what, one for the various entity classes and methods, and another one dedicated to FGD editing. But I wanted to catapult you right into the heart of it, to get a taste of entity programming. In the next part, we'll go through some other entity methods, such as think and touch, as well as some entity properties. I haven't yet fully explained what PEV is and how the game initializes the message variable. All that is coming soon, and until then, happy programming!